Swung on, belted. Outman ranging back. Just missed it. So the Giants leave one. Then it remains 5-3. Man at first. And now it's Mookie Betts. Betts, over 1,000 runs batted in his career. Can't forget to mention he's a former MVP. Cartaya aboard here at first with nobody out. Ground ball left side, could be two. To Jimenez. Back to first, and that is a double play.
Got what he was looking for on the mound right there, and his infielders took care of business. Pretty textbook execution between short and second to turn that into two outs.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Steven Tan. Singy, he's a guy that covers both sides of the plate about as well as anyone in the sport. How difficult is that to do?
Well, just look at the back of my bubblegum card. You'll see how hard it is. These guys are great, man. They have the ability to look out there, but also to be able to turn on the inside pitch. Those that can really sharpen things on the outer half, those are the ones that become elite.
Lays out and makes the play.
Great diving catch to end the inning after the pitcher battles.
Runner at first with two away. Steven Tan now at the plate. Odd choice here. They intentionally walk him, and the runner now into scoring position. So two down. Brian De La Cruz, the next Giant to hit. One strike away. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. The tying and go-ahead runs are left aboard as this one is over.
That looked like the pitcher was getting into a little trouble there, but quickly brought out a pitch that isn't.
So two away with nobody on. And up next for San Francisco, Steven Tan. Here's a rip to short, but he's there for the third out.
That one was ticketed for the gap, but couldn't get through security. Great job there of leaping, making the.
Sebastian Walcott stepping in for the Rangers. And here comes. Rolled to short, possible two ball. Tan to second for one. On to Vaughn, two. No runs, no hits, no errors. We head on now to the top of the third. It's the Giants one and the Rangers nothing. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, Steven Tan.
Steven Tan.
Porter back to work. Base hit center field. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Next to hit, Brian De La Cruz.
The left fielder.
This is a great dynamic right here. Speedy runner at first, thinking about taking second. Catcher with the pop time that leaves jaws on the floor. This might get interesting, Boo.
The 1-2. Runner on the go. And that one is lifted in the air. Garcia makes the catch. Now a throw to first, and he won't get back in time. It's a double play.
Well, we assume it, but not all double play.
Here's Trey Turner. And that one hit to first. There's one.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
The batter, number one. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Line drive, and that's a base hitter to right. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind the way that he's...
Here goes the runner. Line drive, and it gets down for a base hit. Here's the throw to the plate. It's offline. The run comes in.
Comes through with the RBI. Nice line drive to the pull side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Ripped on a line. Tavares makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. And digging in for San Francisco, he gets the intentional walk here, and now will force it any base with two gone. So first and second with two outs. Brian De La Cruz, the next Giant to hit. 3-0 down. Runner on the go. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Well, that sets up a really big at-bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third. In the air, out towards left center. Brings it in, and that's the third out. Two homers in the inning lead to three runs midway in inning number seven. Bottom of the inning, now it's the right fielder, Adolis Garcia. On the ground. In time, Devon. One gone to the bottom of the eighth. So two down. Here's Turner now. On the ground to the left. Tan. Zips it across. And they get Turner for the out. Play made. That's to do it for the Rangers. This one remains close. 6-5. All set to start the ninth in this one. And digging in for San Francisco. Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. A gigantic blast. His latest homer in an incredible season. And they add a run. It's 7-5. That's their third home run of the game.
They're having a lot of fun at the plate in this one. They've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. When you're working with this kind of velocity, trailing by four runs can be pretty tough, especially when there's good pitching on the other side. But these players just kept fighting. They never gave up. And that's why they got back in the ball game and came away with the win in this one.
7 runs by 15 hits. No errors they left.
Do you still cry? And we're back. And on the mound in this one, Steven Tan. Safe to say, he's pretty stingy, Chris.
Well, this guy's just been filthy out there on the mound. Hitters batting under 200 against him, and they're just having a hard time squaring up anything, doing any type of damage. The only way he hurts himself is if he gives up the free passes and surrenders a rare home run. But outside of that, it's going to be a tough job for the opposing lineup today.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Leody Tavares. The pitch. And a foul ball. 1-2 now. That one lifted to left. Bishop on his way over. He's got it. And there's one down. Jace Young digs in now. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. Swings and misses. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Came after him with the fastball on 0-2, and that's a pretty good demonstration of what power pitching is all about. He's got the stuff, obviously, and right there he used it to put his opponent away without needing to waste any pitches.
There's a strike.
Gonna really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. And down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down. Bottom half of inning number two. Here's Nathaniel Lowe. Swings through that one. Lowe, a member of the 1,000 hit club, and he's won a silver slugger in the American League. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. One away.
Quick three-pitch strikeout, and you look at the sequence. The plan was clearly to work him inside. Didn't want to let him get his arms extended, make him a little bit uncomfortable in there, and he ended up overmatching him in the process. That's one you have to take note of as a hitter for next time you come to the plate.
Matt Vierling in the box now. No balls and a strike. Pitch misses, and that's ball one. No score here in the second. Swing, and this one's bounced to the ground. Whips it to first. And that quickly, two away. So next to hit for Texas, Sebastian Wolcott. That pitch gets the corner. That's strike one.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Rolls across the diamond. Three up, three down, inning over. Back at Globe Life Field. Now it's the veteran outfielder, Adolis Garcia. And a foul ball. And now the lefty bounced up the middle. Jimenez. The throw to first, and Garcia is out. Trey Turner now. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Vaughn hauls it in for the out. And there are two down. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Strike two. Up the middle, Jimenez. Whips it to first on the run. They get the out, and that'll do it. Back in Arlington, bottom four, and now it's the Rangers' leadoff hitter, Leody Taveras. And that's off the inside edge, and it's one and one. Just missed.
It's a good take.
Struck him out looking.
Oh, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
Young swings through that one as he comes to the plate for the second time today. Bows it back with two strikes. The Rangers yet to pick up a hit here. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side. And that'll do it. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. They're down 4-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Nathaniel Lowe up to hit as the lefty gets to work. Inside corner, and that's called a strike.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
Got it by him for the K.
Man, there was no deviating from the fastball right there. He just kept coming after it. Here it is. Hit it if you can. And he just couldn't find a way to put it in play. Now, this guy is just filling up the strike zone right now. Don't want to get yourself in an 0-2 hole. You better be ready to pull the trigger on the first pitch.
The 0-2. And they'll do it again. One down, base is empty. That's towards center. Sizing this one up. And there's two away. And the batter will be the shortstop, Sebastian Wolcott. Strike on the inside corner. It's 0-1. Wolcott, in his second season, 25 years old, and he was born in the Bahamas. Swing and a miss. And the count, 1-2. And a ground ball to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Bottom of the sixth inning, and here is Adolis Garcia. There's a strike.
I'm impressed by the number of first pitch strikes. He's not afraid of contact. Some guys, they'll nibble just because they don't want to get hit hard. That's not what we're seeing here.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Foul ball. And a swing and a miss there. He goes down looking.
Oh, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
Two outs, bases empty. The batter now will be Will Smith. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Two outs. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And it's a three up, three down inning. Rangers go down quickly there. They continue to trail 7-0. Is this redemption for my soul? And we're back. Here's the center fielder, Leody Taveras.
This pitcher's done a good job of disrupting the hitter's timing with the mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent for the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound.
There's a strike.
Seems like the hitters are struggling with their timing today, kind of caught in between that sharp fastball and the nasty slider. I'd like to see him settle on a consistent pitch.
In the air, left field. Bishop pulls it down, and there's one down. Here's the third baseman, Jace Young.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Off the mark there. Now one and two. Bounce to the right. And that one handled. Throws to first in time. Two outs, base is empty. So now it's Corey Seager. Swings through that one for strike one.
You know, he's been so great today, really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaken off the catcher very much at all today.
And Seager is set down. And back at Globe Life Field, onto the bottom of the eighth. And here's the first baseman, Nathaniel Lowe. The pitch. Right through there for a strike. Tan into his eighth inning of work, Singy. He's been good.
Yeah, he's the type of guy that gets better as he gets deeper into the ball game. If you're going to get to him, you get to him early. They didn't do that today. We'll see what happens as this finishes.
First pitch just misses. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Mejia squeezes it, two down.
Man, he's getting really close to this thing right now. Only four outs left, but it's going to be tough to get.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Two down, nobody on. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Tan makes the grab on the run. Back in Arlington, all set for the bottom of the ninth. And now the right fielder, Adolis Garcia.
I'll tell you right now, every player defensively on their toes like never before.
And now one and two.
They want to make sure they have the opportunity to put this pitcher in the history books. They are going to make the play.
Caught him looking for the K. He's two outs away. Trey Turner at the plate.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
Late on that fastball. Base is empty, one away. Here in the last half of inning number nine.
I mean, his pitch efficiency, ability to get ahead in the count, at times pitch to contact, let the defense work behind him. That's why he's still in the game here in the ninth inning.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. In there for strike one. You just don't see it that much anymore, a guy being this efficient and getting this deep into the game.
I wonder if he's going to be able to close it out. There's just something about
that ninth inning. But being at under 100 pitches, he's still got plenty of fuel left in the tank.
Tan is just one strike away. Right through there, got him. Ball game.
Just unbelievable. I was nervous up here in the booth. I can only imagine what his teammates and even he felt out there on the mound closing this thing out. Everyone will remember this perfect game, and it'll be notched in Cooperstown forever.
Now here is Stephen Tan.
Batting third, the shortstop, Stephen Tan.
Fastball in for a strike, going one. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. And that's a double. So two in scoring position with one out. Brian De La Cruz, the next Giant to hit. Two on, one out. On the ground, right side. Turner with the throw to first. But the go-ahead run comes in to score. Walker Jenkins getting ready to hit. Two outs. And he grounds one to the right side. Over to Lowe. They limit the damage here. So up next, Jace Young. On the ground, left side, six. And that's a base hit. Lead runner around second. And now runners at the corners, nobody out.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Paredes, one at second. And a run scores on the double play. Start of the fourth, and digging in for San Francisco, Stephen Tan. The line and the pitch. That one is absolutely belted. Tavares ranging back on it. See you later. That'll fire up the dugout.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Holds it in on the warning track. Runner tags at second.
It was all over that fastball right there. I tell you what, if he gets on.
And we're back. And up to the plate is Will Smith. Out to short. Tan. Gets it to first, and they get the out on Smith. Base is empty, one away. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Stephen Tan. Warning track, wall, and you can touch them all, baseball man. two-hitter homer. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's Trey Turner. And the righty deals. Bounced out to short. Tan. Throws to first in time. Turner is out. Will Smith stepping in for the Rangers. Out to short. Slings to first, and they get the out on Smith. Tan made a big contribution despite the loss. Collected three hits, including two home runs. Now from Coors Field at the foot of the Rocky Mountains in Denver, Colorado, an NL West matchup on the show. It's the San Francisco Giants going up against the Colorado. Man at first. Now it's the shortstop, Steven Tan. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. On a line, base hit. Lead runner around second. The throw in, and the throw's offline, safe at third. Runners at the corners here, one away. Digging in, Brian De La Cruz. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. Throw to second, safe. Chris, his wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one. Oh, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow, Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Popped up. He's under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Next to hit for the Rockies, Sean Bouchard. Out to short. In time to Vaughn, and that is the inning. Smash to center, way back, and you can forget it. Home run. A gigantic blast. His latest homer in an incredible season. And they boost their lead.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Steven Tan.
Warning track, wall, and you can touch them all, baseball man. Another homer.
Hey, here we go, big guy. Come on.
And that's a strike.
These two guys, a lot of respect for one another.
And a foul ball. That one is absolutely belted. And it's a one-hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. And he's got a double, his fourth hit. Now the left fielder, Brian De La Cruz. Runner takes off. On the ground to third. Can't field it cleanly. Gets it there in time, though. And they come away with an out. We go to the ninth. And digging in for San Francisco, Steven Tan. Lerma back to work. And that one fouled off.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That's a hit. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Brian De La Cruz, the next Giant to hit. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Grounded to third. Could be two. Quick feed to second for one. How about that double play?
As a former player, watching.
Bottom of the inning. Here's the second baseman, John McDonough. Line drive. And that gets down into the gap. In safely at second base, and that's the potential winning run with nobody out.
He was all over that one. Put a really nice balanced swing on it, and when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box, and he'll feel real good about that one. Winning run in scoring position now, so a clutch AB could end this one.
For our ball game for the Victoria Blackhawks.
Steven Tan, the next Giant to hit. There's a swing and a drive. Banks off the wall. Around first and hustling for second. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
He's been swinging it really well lately. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third. Out to short. Oh, a great grab on the dive. And they get the out. Crushed. Left center field. This one's deep. Forget it.
Like he's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's a tip.
Sean Bouchard digging in for the Rockies. To the right side, boots it, and he's gonna make it to first, and we'll see how they score it. First and second, no outs. So in now for Colorado, Adael Amador. The 0-1. Hit on the ground. Might be two. Jimenez. One at second. On to Vaughn. Two.
That was a much-needed double play right there. It gives him a really good shot at minimizing.
Lundy back to work. Smash to center. Way back. And you can forget it. Home run.
You're working with this kind of velocity.
New inning getting started. And now the shortstop, Steven Tan.
No matter what, you're playing this kind of rival to take your game to another level.
The pitch. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. And it hits the fence. Round second, digging for third. The relay, the tag, and he's out, trying for three. Out towards right center, that's well struck. And it hits the fence. And he's got a double. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind.
Runner breaks for third. Swing and a high fly ball left field. And that is that.
This team secures a winning season with the W today, and regardless of what else happens the rest of the way, you know that you're a winning ball club. So a little bit of pressure off, put your foot on the gas, and just see where you can finish from this point on.
Our final line score this afternoon, first for the victorious Giants, 8 runs on 19.
Steven Tan, the next Giant to hit.
Come on, baby. Stay out up there, kid.
There's a strike. Hawkins. In his rookie season, he features a four-seam fastball, a changeup, a slider, a curve, and he works in a sinker. On the ground a second, might be two. There's one, and that's two. The batter will be the shortstop, Adael Amador. Ground ball left side, could be two. There's one, and that's two. In the air out to center. Couser under it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. One out, base is empty. Sean Bouchard digging in for the Rockies. Swing and a ground ball out to short. To first, and he's out.
Yeah, I'm looking at his body language in each.
Base is empty with two away. Here's the Rockies cleanup hitter, Colton Couser. Hard hit left side. Whips it across, and that ends the inning. One hit in the inning, a solo homer. Five innings complete. All tied up. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. And digging in for San Francisco, Steven Tan. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone.
With a low 90s fastball.
And we're back. We go to the eighth. Now it's the shortstop, Steven Tan. That smash towards center. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
Man, he's smoked.
Back here in Denver, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Adael Amador. Tan. The throw to first. One up, one down.
These players just want to keep it rolling right now. You win this series, you got another team coming in, and you want to do exactly the same.
Yeah. next man, but next man ain't with the plans. Who got your heart in mind? It's about time.
In this building, they are fired up for game one. Back with that after this. Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. We've got game one of the National League Division Series. It's the Miami Marlins taking on the San Francisco Giants. Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Schompen. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go down. And today's starting pitcher, Shane Baz.
Four-pitch guy, he's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them
onto Jimenez, and that'll do it. And now the shortstop, Stephen Tan. Year in and year out, this guy an MVP candidate. Warning track, ball, and you can touch them all, baseball man. And we're all square. It's 1-1.
Guy's got a real hard fastball. You can't overswing. All you've got to do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
Back here at Oracle Park, now it's the rookie first baseman, number 50. Rickson Windrow. Gotta love the intensity of postseason baseball. Players on both sides at such a high level of emotion, everything is amplified. On the ground. Slings to first. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Talk about that intensity, Boo. It comes out of everybody. Think about celebrations by players like Carlos Correa. Up next to the
Giants. I wouldn't get too puffed up about that postseason extra base hit thing, Siggy. The all-time leader with four is Ken Holtzman, a pitcher. And one of his hits was a homer.
Yeah, Boo. I'm sure he was a position player, though, before he started pitching.
Man at first, one away. In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and another homer. His second home run of the game. It's 3-1.
Well, that one won't stay below the radar. That made a lot of noise.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
So digging in, Jake Berger.
You have to be careful throwing him breaking pitches, even in an 0-0 count. He loves going after the off-speed stuff, and he's really good at hitting it.
And here it comes. On the ground, could be two. goes to second for one. A 3-6-1 double play.
The 3-6-1 double play, in my opinion, is one of the toughest plays to make. You've got a pitcher covering first and the middle infielder throwing to a moving target. Everything has to be perfect, and right there, they made it look pretty easy.
Leading up. And up next for San Francisco, Steven Tan. He's got a couple homers already, so could he possibly do it again?
Come on, man. Of course he can. Those two he hit were legit, and he looks pretty locked in right now if he did.
The wind of the pitch. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
No waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Next is the designated hitter, Brian De La Cruz. With the tying run at the plate here in game one of the NLDS. There goes the runner. There's the ball. Throw to second. Ow!
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw. Quick.
One down. Steven Tan, the next Giant to hit. 3-for-3 with a pair of home runs and a single. And that one is lifted in the air. Crow Armstrong should have it. Out number two.
Now back.
Ryan Clifford, the next up for the Marlins. Hit on the ground to the right side. Gone. Over to second. They get the out, but the run scores on the twin killer.
First and third, nobody out. You're thinking you've got it lined up for a pretty big inning right here. So that double play is pretty deflating. They get the run in, but now they're starting all over.
Tan was a real bright spot despite the loss. Cracked a pair of homers.
No question, he was a big contributor for him here. Fantastic effort at the plate, even in defeat.
7-3 is how this one ends. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon. Just about ready to go, and on the hill today, Luis Polito. Chris, how about a scouting report?
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot.
And there's a rocket into the outfield. Around third, he will score, and they take the lead. 1-0. Tan into second, and he's got a double. Here's the tag, and he's that one ripped. That's back. Tattooed and gone. He's up to 3 home runs in the series, and they tack on to their lead. It's 3-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now. We
When you're working with this kind of velocity, so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity, he was all over that fastball.
We're in the second game of this division series. And now the DH, Ryan Clifford. Out to short. What a stop! From his backside, on target. He got him. Nice play.
Great cat-like reflexes right there. Lays out, knocks the ball down, and then fires with that rocket arm all the way across the diamond. Man, put this guy on the mound.
Now batting.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation. So maybe a long relief guy to not start an inning, to come into an inning.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. A gigantic blast. His second home run of the game, it's 8-0. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. To the game. First pitch out of the bullpen, a tough one. You know he's just trying to get one in there for a strike. And on the other side is a hitter. It's a great time to be aggressive and let it fly. It's not what they were looking for when they turned to him, but now he's got to find a way.
Steven Tan, the next Giant to hit. 3 for 3. He's got a double and a pair of home runs. That's ripped. Base hit. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed, and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Gonzalez deals. Here goes the runner, Berger. Zips it to first, and one away in the bottom of the seventh. One out, runner at second. Walker Jenkins, the next Giant to hit. Left-hand hitter waits. Runner takes off for third. Left field, Kwan under it. Makes the grab, and there's two gone. So two down, Andrew Vaughn now. Two outs. Runner breaks for third. Pitch misses. Out at third. And that ends the inning.
For this team, game two of the series at home after dropping game one. They win it today. They feel a lot better heading to the next ballpark for game three.
Score for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Schaub. Thanks for joining us. So two away with nobody on. Steven Tan, the next Giant to hit. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Crow Armstrong makes the catch, inning over. Giants go to... That one fouled off. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first here in game three of the NLDS. Swung on, belted. That's back there. Tattooed and gone. He'll touch them all. That's his fifth homer of the series. It's 2-0. That's his third straight game with a homer, Singy.
This dude is on fire, Boog. These kinds of streaks just don't come around too often. Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? Well, a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
In the air, right center. This is mashed way back and gone.